Dr. Enamul Haque of Bangladesh is an archaeologist, museologist, poet. Indeed, he is a man of varied colors. He was honored with Padmashree this year. He spoke to Prasar Bharati special correspondent Rajesh Jha in Dhaka.
My getting this Padmashree is a great, I consider it as a great honor for me, because I do not usually expect that from a foreign country like this, from India at least, I will get any such state award in that way. So when I read it in the newspaper that Pratnatattvabid Enamul Haque, someone is archaeologist Enamul Haque, I said, it is me, it is. But I think that in considering me as a candidate for this Padmashree, the authority, Indian authority, took into consideration some other things also, that I was not an archaeologist only. I can tell you how you would like to hear it, that I am a poet. I have got 9 books on poetry and 1 collection of poems. And then I am an archaeologist, you see. I have gone on excavation, exploration, report, and many aspects of archaeology I have covered in Bangladesh.
Going beyond archaeology, Dr. Haque is a musician also. He has written dance dramas, and he spoke about the dance dramas of Gurudev Rabindranath Tagore and his own contributions in this field.
And then I am a musician also, a lyricist. I have composed modern songs, and I have composed 4 lyrical dance drama. This is something I have to explain that.
And to illustrate the point, he sings a few lines of his own composition in his deep, forceful voice.
Sadinata bolbar, sadinata cholbar, likbar, gaibar, bachbar, bhaggo ke bhangte, haste ki kante, chai sab korbar, odhikar. This is from a dance drama of mine. This 4 lines, music, is that 4 lines of music. And then something, 4 lines from a sonnet. The sonnet, as you know, comes with 14 lines, but I will only recite the last 4 lines. Ami take ghrina kori, je amake nipun kaushale, irsha ba abogga diye thele daye pritak mahale. Ami take ghrina kori, je amake nipun kaushale, irsha ba abogga diye thele daye pritak mahale. Shatruraja bhabe, ami serokom noi bhoyano.
And then he continues to explain the history of Tagore's dance dramas.
Everybody is not composing a dance drama. It was Tagore who did it first when he was only 18 or 19 years old after his return from England. And then the 3 dance dramas were Balmiki Pratibha, Rubichhaya, and Mayar Khala. These were the mostly the emphasis was on the music. Anyhow, after these 3 lyrical dance drama, Tagore, for whatever reason I do not know, kept silent for so many years, nearly 50 or 55 years. He did not write any more dance dramas. He composed songs, used the songs in his dramas, etc. But the dance dramas were not there. But when he was 74 or 75, then again he came back to compose dance dramas. He did Chitrangada, he did Chandalika, he did Shyama, and they all of them were very popular. And in fact, my introduction to this dance drama began with these 3 dance dramas. And I was intimately connected with these dramas from the year Tagore's centenary.
During those times of Pakistani oppression over Bangladesh, singing Tagore and Nazrul was an act of courage, a challenge to the military might of Pakistan.
We were involved with Tagore's these three dramas during his centenary year. And it was for another reason that at that time, Pakistani military junta who were ruling Bangladesh, they would not allow Tagore song on radio or television. They would not allow tikka on the forehead. So they would not allow any Bengali name to your children. So one after another, these things were coming as an oppression on us. And so we stood up and resisted it. So it was with another reason that we were very forcefully doing Tagore's dance drama during the centenary when the military government was there. Anyhow, that was that. And we always loved Tagore. He was our guide during the time of War of Liberation in 1971. We were singing dozens of Tagore songs as we were singing dozens of Nazrul songs.
Dr. Enamul Haque is passionate about Bengal art. He talked about his efforts to promote the study of Bengal art through the International Center for the Study of Bengal Art that he set up along with his wife.
I did that. Myself and my wife, we established the International Center for Study of Bengal Art. This is something. There are more than 100 universities in Bangladesh, but none of them teaches Bengal art. So what is to be done? So 25 years ago, my wife and myself, we decided to donate our entire academic collection, 20,000 books and journals, more than half of which are the only copies in Bangladesh, and 60,000 photographs. So these were unique collection, and we gave it free, of course, to the government of India to establish an autonomous body. At this moment, we are negotiating with the government how it will be done. But our decision is final that we will give this collection to the people.
Dr. Enamul Haque spoke about his educational journey from Bogura School to Dhaka University and then to the study of museology in Britain.
I was born in Bogura in North Bengal in 1936. I first studied in free primary school, very ordinary school. Then I went to Bogura Jela School, that was a government school. And from Jela School, I passed my matriculation. Then I went to Bogura Ajizul Haque College. I passed the intermediate of science at both places in first division. And then from intermediate of science, I came to Dhaka, in Dhaka University, to get admission in history department. So after studying science, I came to history because there are difficulties to appear in examination from the jail, because I was in prison for taking part in state language movement. You might have heard about this thing that in 1954 and 1955. So that's why from science I came to history, and from history to archaeology. These were the education of that level. But this, my study, another thing, I studied museology. This was a very exceptional subject. In this subcontinent, I was the second person to study museology, means the museum studies from England. So this gave me a very extraordinary opportunity to understand the museum techniques and how to run the museum, etc. And I went to other countries. I could even speak to those people also with my knowledge of museology. So this brought me into an international arena when I was talking about museology. That was.
Dr. Haque has done invaluable work in preserving the archaeological heritage of Bangladesh. His work, especially in the field of Hindu iconography, is considered extremely important.
The study of sculptures, what we call iconography, was not being done in Bangladesh or even in India in that way. So, in Bangladesh, we were doing, and when I went to Oxford in 1970 to do a dissertation for my D.Phil, I selected the subject as the Hindu iconography. And my supervisor asked me, "Haque, are you not a Muslim?" I said, "Yes, sir." He said, "Then you are taking up a Hindu subject?" I said, "Yes, sir." "And you think that when you go back to Pakistan, you may be in trouble?" I said, "Sir, I will take care of that myself." So I was doing that dissertation. In less than 3 years, I studied 1,860 Hindu sculptures of Bengal. 1,860 sculptures of Bengal. An all-time record. I'm not belittling other scholars, but this study of so many sculptures have improved the identifications of earlier scholars, etc. And I am very happy that I was involved with such a study. I could study many Hindu iconographic texts, and based on them, I could say that the iconography was improved a lot.
Dr. Enamul Haque played a key role in establishing the National Museum of Bangladesh. He was its founder, director general also. From a small beginning, the museum is one of the largest in the world today.
I got the job in the then Dhaka Museum, very small museum of 5,000 or 6,000 square feet of floor space, and no funding from government properly. So in 1962, I joined it, and my principal work was to raise funds to run it. And this was going on till our freedom, war of independence going on. Then even after the independence, the museum was not getting very good support from the government. But after some time, when we met with Bangabandhu Sheikh Mujibur Rahman, our situation improved, and improved gradually, so we could build a very sumptuous building, which is in the newer part of the Dhaka city called Shahbag. And there we built up a museum, new museum building, which had about 300,000 square feet of floor space. It is nearly the largest national museum in the third world. So we are very proud of it. So this was my great pleasure that I had the role to play to build up this national museum. It was not only the building of the building, though we built this building, we also collected materials, and that was our very important aspect of work. Because at that time, things all over the world was going on, the clandestine collection of antiquities and works of art were going out of each country. Bangladesh, India and such countries were losing things. We were losing things and we had to compete with those who were doing this business. And we really could collect quite some number of the Hindu and Buddhist sculptures, you see. When in 1947 the many Hindus left Bangladesh, they threw their sculptures into the tank pond or somewhere in case they are disintegrated. So they went away. So we did not know the situation of these sculptures. And then in 1971, another great upheaval, that the Hindus, when they were leaving Bangladesh, they threw away their sculptures in that way. And my responsibility was, when I joined, I was trying to find out these lost objects. And I recollected many of them, and any important sculptures which were lost to us, I could recollect them. I had obtained help from public. They cooperated with us. And in this, it is still going on, that we know that some sculptures are not there where they should be. But ultimately, we have recovered that.
Bangladesh has many important archaeological sites. Dr. Haque was keenly involved in the excavation and exploration of these sites. He talked about the treasure of these sites which need to be further explored.
Well, it is not only sculptures that we have studied in Bangladesh. It's nearly 50 years ago or so, new sites have been discovered in Bangladesh, quite a few. The one before that, some 70 years ago, when the History of Bengal Volume 1 was published from Dhaka University. It was an undivided Bengal at that time. So only Paharpur was known to the scholars, that greatest Buddhist stupa, and Bihar, only this Paharpur was known. But after the establishment of Pakistan, our archaeologists, they discovered Moinamati in the Kumilla district. And gradually they started excavating that. And so far, 12 mounds have been excavated and a large number of antiquities have been found, copper plates, sculptures, etc. And this has opened up new vista for the archaeology of Bangladesh. This is, and not only Bangladesh, it has also helped identify many things in West Bengal, that there are 49 mounds in Moinamati. We have only excavated 12. That means much more are still lying buried in Moinamati mounds. So the archaeologists have a duty, great duty for the future. These have to be unearthed and excavated and studied.
Dr. Haque is keen on closer cooperation between India and Bangladesh to expand and develop the field of history and archaeology.
And now that I have been acknowledged with an award of Padmashree by Government of India, I will expect that the Government of India will give us much more attention and some sort of help, financial or administrative or somewhere, because unless there is help from government in these matters, we cannot make any progress in archaeology. So it will be my urge to the government of both sides that you sit down and work out what is to be done to develop the archaeological excavations, writing reports, publishing books, etc. I would also suggest something, that India has many monuments, renowned, and of different periods, of different religion and of something. Bangladesh has also many, but not equal to India in any way. So I would suggest that, because government of India is much more stronger than us, in a sense, richer than us. So they can take initiative in arranging visits by Bangladeshi students to Indian sites and monuments, and similarly, the Indian students can come to Bangladesh to visit the sites and monuments. This will really will build up a close relationship between the two people. This is something, there are tourism going on here and there in Bangladesh and in India, but I would go particularly for the students. So that we can develop close relationship between us.
After getting Padma Shri, Dr. Enamul Haque expressed his desire to visit India.
Well, if you ask me about my wish, one of them is definitely to go to India as many times as possible, because great country, many things to see and enjoy. So I look forward to getting an opportunity to go to India.
By conferring Padma Shri on Dr. Enamul Haque, India has honored the shared heritage of India and Bangladesh. It is indeed an honor for all those who have dedicated their life to scholarship and social work in the Indian subcontinent. Rajesh Jha for AIR and DD News, Dhaka.